Sridhar. I have been working as a director of projects for ATG, Export Trading Group. It's a Kenyan originated company. I'll call it as an African multinational. We are a conglomerate, end-to-end supply chain companies. ATG's production, 80% of ATG's procurement is directly from the smallholder farmers. We have a lot of takeaways for us to take from this project. First and foremost, we were able to reach 9,000 plus farmers, going to them, working through them, developing and training them in the climate smart practices. 10,000 farmers, 9,000 farmers were benefited by this program. Second, teaching them the way in which they can do the crop which they've been traditionally doing. That's PGNP. That's the second takeaway. Third, we ourselves learned a lot from this project. Previously, climate smart means we thought of one small narrow angle. Often we used to confuse it with organic. Organic is equal to climate smart. Sorry, it is not that way. When we went in to train the farmers, train the trainers and all like that, we got into the topic. We were working with our country heads, UNA country representatives. So we learned a lot about climate smart. In that way, it is an eye-opener for us to inculcate, to impart, work with climate smart.
My name is Sarah Ngwenya. I am from Zambia. I am the CEO of Kalomo Grain Marketing Limited. We are into production of grain for multiplication, and this grain is given to smallholder farmers, particularly women. The women are naturally motivated by the problems that they are facing. So you find that when there's a project, they involve themselves with everything that they have. In Zambia, climate change has affected the farmers in the way that you find that when you grow, there's no rain, and some of the seed that we grow, they are not drought resistant. So farmers would grow, like ourselves, we were growers as well, and will not produce anything. Now, they're coming up with VUNA through GMT. It just entailed us that we can grow now drought resistant crops, which are all the legume seeds, including cowpeas, pigeon pea, soya beans, and the beans, the traditional beans. When we started, we were at 30, we got 20 hectares of seed, and now we are at 300 hectares of seed that we've grown, and that is in all the varieties that VUNA is championing.
My name is Bertha Mianda Simuyandi. I'm the executive secretary, popularly known as the CEO, for the Zambia Cotton Engineers Association. I decided to work with VUNA because I saw an opportunity for the smallholder farmers to practice climate smart agricultural practices. From the little knowledge I've acquired over the past year that we have worked with VUNA, climate smart agriculture has got several practices that helps smallholder farmers. These include crop rotation, maintaining good soil health through trees such as the Phaidebia albida, which is locally known as the Musango tree, which smallholder farmers plant in their demo plots. It also has to do with integrated pest management, how they manage pests locally within their environment to ensure that their crops are not affected by these pests.
We worked in partnership with VUNA in supporting a climate smart seeds for semi-arid areas, which was looking at three districts in Zimbabwe, which are Mberengwa, Bikita and Mwenezi. The main target was to support the production of quality CSA seed to smallholder farmers in the three districts. So VUNA provided us with technical support and also funds for implementation, which covered mostly the human resources, equipment, and some operational costs. This project was necessary because we were introducing new seed varieties into areas that had not received those kind of seeds. Also, there were also climate smart technologies that the farmers were being taught, which means this was going to increase their ability to be resilient to climate change. I think the work we have done with VUNA has seen our production in terms of the volume of seed rise from 460 metric tons to 1,000 metric tons. This has actually increased what we can call the turnover for the business, and we feel we'll keep the momentum going post the project. And to us, we're not running a project. We want this to be a normal and sustainable business.